That one's rot. I have to give him his pull again. You know why? He's got another big crappie. Oh boy, Jay, look at this. Another monster. I feel guilty bringing it in, folks, seriously.
No, bring it in.
Okay, hear what he said? The chef said, yeah. Bring it in. Oh my goodness, Jay.
Ho, ho, ho! How's everybody on this beautiful festive season? We're gonna put together a video called the Top 10 Best Places to Catch Crappie. Some of my most exciting locations, some of my most exciting techniques and tactics that I've learned over the years fishing with some fantastic crappie fishermen. So without further ado, how about we just get to the meat of the video. First and foremost, big thanks to my buddy Tim Blackley from Tennessee. He opened a lot of doors for me, introduced me to people, industry folks, a lot of good anglers and stuff, and some phenomenal fishing, man. And I mean, that guy is a spider rigging guru, really, from the techniques of how to go slow, the depths, the trolling speed, how to set the baits and stuff. And I'm telling you, man, when you do it a few times, if you've never done it before, how many rods out there in your sleep, you will see those poles in your sleep bouncing and watching them. But without further ado, let's get to Tim and some Kentucky Lake crappie with the spider rig, because it's a deadly way to cover water fast, catch crappie, and then eat crappie. Let's go.
That might be Mr. Crappie. Oh, oh my goodness. Lordy, lordy.
Net.
Come in here to daddy, baby. Look what a crappie coming in here.
You want net?
No, I get him.
Okay. Atta boy.
He looks hooked up.
Hey, right, Tim Blackley.
That's the way you start a day right there now.
Wow. Oh, yeah.
Look, what a mouth. Woo! Thank you, baby. See, they still lean. They ain't fattened up for winter yet.
Yes.
That fish will make a big old fish.
He's going in.
More like a bass, long and skinny.
That's a boxer, huh?
That's a good fish.
Going in the box.
Okay, who doesn't like float fishing for crappie? Everybody does it, man, from spring to fall. Something about watching that little cork, you know, could be any age from 8 to 80. Just watching that little cork, hopefully just twitches, falls over, or goes under. Me, I love crappie fishing with a float. It's a deadly way, an exciting way to catch crappie.
Okay, when it comes to slip floats, think about it. For crappie, you can't beat it. The ones that slide are the best ones. They don't hurt your line, they don't damage it, put any abrasions on. You just get used to moving your little bobber stop back and forth. Easy peasy, boy. And the little crappie magnets, those are the ones that help you catch. And the little 1/16 ounce, in this case, I was using the Northern Tackle Supply, real sharp mustads, because crappie, although they can be small, they can be scrappy. So have all the tools of the trade in the chain, you'll catch them with slip float.
Float shouldn't have lasted that long. Someone's there.
Dunk right away. Like that? What do you got?
Whoa,
there?
Big one.
Netter?
Yeah, it is.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. I'll come on the left side here, Josh. Wow.
The head shaking.
Yeah, man.
There we go.
I just finished saying, when they're on the right spot, this one could have been single pulled, but look how it ate it too. Aggressive bite, man. I twitched that float, twitched the float, and dude, it went, got it right here, thanks, yeah. Dude, it went pop, just like that. Oh, man.
Beautiful.
Oh, man.
Off the tree.
Yeah.
That was cool.
Beautiful. Beautiful crappies, look at that, eh? Wow. Sure fun. Look how big that mouth is. And they pop in that bait.
Okay, side pulling for crappie. Do you even know what that even means? I had no idea what it was until I hooked up with this guy, Brad Whitehead from Alabama, who showed me that we were going to pull little jigs, two jigs at a time, different sizes, sideways in his boat. Originated by a guy named Roger Gant. They got special poles, they got special ways to do it. It's a deadly, deadly technique to catch crappie when they're suspended chest off bottom in the heat of the summer of Alabama.
Here's what we're gonna do today. It's fairly simple technique. We're gonna be fishing with two different kind of baits. We're gonna be fishing with a hair jig. They're 2/4 ounce hair jigs. I like something heavy. I wanna move fast. I wanna move a lot, have a, cover a lot of water. and you've got to have a lot of weight to cover a lot of water. And it's really neat what we're gonna do. These jigs are 2 foot apart. What we're gonna do, we're gonna lay the top jig in the water, and these B&M poles that we have, they're called the Difference, and they're designed for this style of fishing, side pulling. It's an 8'2" rod. It's 8 feet long. It's a two-piece rod. And if you notice, it's got 3 little flags here. And we're going to consider that a pull. And what I mean by a pull is we know our fish. We're sitting in 21 to 22 foot of water. We know our fish are anywhere from 2 to 4 foot off the bottom. All right. What we're going to do is literally count down to them and keep our jigs in a strike zone at all times. What we're going to do, we're going to pull off 20 pulls. But we're going to start with 3. And why we start with 3 is because we've already got 2 foot in the water. We try to make this as precise as we can. What we're going to do, we're going to pull off. We're going to go 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. We're fishing. We'll click the rod over, lay it in the rod holder, and we're ready to go. Now here in Alabama, we can use multiple rods. There's only 2 lakes in Alabama that you've got a pole in. So I think the more rods, the more baits, the more fish we can catch. And that seems to work very well for us. So we're gonna get a few more of these rigged up, get Carl rigged up, and try to put some fish in. Aha, caught right. It, Carl.
Netter?
Nah, we're all right.
Oh, nice fish. Ho, ho, ho. Look at the mouth on that. Oh, buddy, nice crappie.
Whoo, didn't let me down. I was a little nervous with that one. A little nervous.
In the meat, you need the pliers?
I got it.
Beautiful fish, and you called it. He said, get ready. I was ready, but it was on that rod. As long as it's in the boat, doesn't matter, Brad.
That's right.
You know what that is, don't you, boys? Hey, jig pole, bottom reel seat. I don't know if there's a more exciting way to stock the slabs. One-on-one, a big pole in any depths you want to fish. I fish it from 8 inches of water to 20 plus something feet with different guys in different locations, all the way across the states and across Canada as well. The single poling, one-on-one to crappie, is one of the most exciting ways I know to catch crappie.
Oh my goodness. Look at Hoss. Hoss, come here. Oh my goodness, hey? Hoss and the boss. Now I'm getting all cocky, eh? Look at that. Look at that. Seriously, look where he's got it. Come on, man. Look at that. Seriously. There's no way you miss those. But man, you gotta pay attention. Pay attention to what you're doing, man. Watch it, just like your largemouth fishing. Another beautiful fish, man. Seriously, let's see. Oh no, you're all skinny and stuff, man. You ain't doing business. I need a crappie feed.
Shooting docks for crappie. What a technique to get your little shad-like bait way underneath a pontoon boat or dock section. I've done it everywhere, man, from Alabama to Ontario to Texas and stuff. And fishing in this one trip, Cedar Creek Lake with George Nealon, man, oh man, getting down on our knees and stuff and pounding those little jigs way back in the little nook and cranny locations, way back underneath those docks where crappie like to hide. But they can hide, but they want to bite.
Felt good, George?
Did.
First fish of the day we lost.
That's a jinx.
Oh no. What if we don't catch any today?
Oh, we will.
I had to say it, right? Oh, I see where he's
here
going.
Here we go.
I see that pendulum. He's way back there. I'm only about 50 feet away from where he hooked that fish. Let's see. How about that one?
Oh, look at that.
Oh yeah. Never alone, are they?
No.
It's about finding the depth they're at, right?
That's right. We just need one. Then we'll know. There he is.
Whoa, is this
good fish?
Oh, look at this. Yay! Cedar Creek Lake, my first crappie of the year.
Felt black bigger. Crappie.
He fought good down there, man. I thought, here we go. Now we're going to keep some bigger ones, 10 plus, right?
Yes.
Maybe we're going to get some slobs, big black and white slobs. But for now, you little bugger, you fought good, man, down there. Boy, got caught around the piling. I thought, oh. But that first fish always feels the biggest, eh, George?
Yep.
Nothing to compare to. Bye.
Those black crappie will fight.
Yeah, little stubbies. That's what I'm using today, right here. Okay, I got tore up a bit. Who cares? But little 16th ounce, like George said, that one tore me up.
Man, you talk about adventure. We got it here. You know what? Fishing in the swamps in Lafayette, Louisiana, with a couple of good old boys and stuff, fishing, I think it was called Goose Island Lake or something like that, right in the swamps, man. I mean, incredible, in summertime. And he says, man, we have to get out the water by 10 because it even gets too hot for the local boys to fish. So we fished those areas with a small John boat, and he made sure, the guy Brian, to tell me, can you swim good? Because if you look around, you see those stumps that are around the boat? They're not stumps. They're alligators. So if you do fall in, when you set hook, Carl, you're on your own.
A place like this inspires you to come down, because I'm telling you, there's places in the world that you want to see with your own eyes. Not on the internet, not on Google, but with your own eyes. This is one of those places that give you the awe. Just coming here, looking at it, and saying the wow factor. So I'm here for the sockeye, the entertainment, and the really good Cajun food. So let's just work along here, have some fun, catch some fish. Let's go. I've been very fortunate over the years to be able to travel to some classic crappie fishing destinations across the United States and Canada. But this trip to Lafayette, Louisiana was truly a bucket list adventure. Just getting to the fishing location was a voyage in itself. Traveling up the main river basin to the fish camp, transferring all our gear for a short land portage, carefully watching our steps while crossing the swamps on makeshift bridges, then loading all of our gear once again into the small John boats with the unique power sources that cut through the very thick hydrilla.
And you definitely want to be up when you hit a stump.
Yes. Like that?
Like that.
Stump jumping, huh? Right on, dude. Right on. And we're off. Huh? Well, you sure can't beat this view, you know? Some people say that catching is actually a bonus.
Yeah.
Well, I want to catch, right?
We want plenty of bonuses today.
That's right. Everyone wants to catch. Catch some crappie, sockeye.
But it's called fishing right now. It's not called catching right now.
That's right. So that's all I'm doing. Brian said just go up a little bit. It's search and destroy. Go up, drift,
yep.
Cast.
Stick and move.
Yep. And when we start catching, it changes to bust and move, huh?
Yeah.
Just bust and move.
There he is.
And you got him.
The cork just stood up. He ain't too big.
Sockeye? Yep.
He's a filleter.
Yep. There's the one I lost.
That's the one. That's
no,
the
mine
one
was a lot bigger, by the way.
Yeah.
That's all right. They're usually never by themselves. That's the best part of these, aren't they?
Yeah.
There you go. Sockeye. Good one. Good one. And right after that twitch. Right after that twitch.
Oh, look, there we go.
Nice one too, huh? Oh, yes.
That's a nice one.
That's what I'm looking for, huh? That's what you get in Lafayette. Look at that, right through the nose, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Right after the twitch. You know, a little, and then, boom, he stood. I think we're gonna put him in the camera boat because that's where our cooler is. We need to have some room. So we're gonna put him in there. But look at the nice backs on them. Good fillets on these fish, huh?
Oh yeah, that's some healthy fish.
Yeah, and they fight good too.
You can see, they, oh yeah. They got plenty, their little bass over here look like little footballs.
Yeah,
so.
They got spunk. Spunk, that's why I like you. But I love you more because they taste good. We'll just put them here in the box.
Okay, when's a good time to get off the bank? We love to pound the shorelines, getting those little sloughs and stuff for spring crappie or even fall crappie in shallow water. But boy, oh boy. I mean, if you don't get off that shore and decide to follow those pre-spawn slabs, roaming the mud flats, 20 plus feet of water before spawn, you're missing out on some of the biggest, baddest black King Kong crappie you're ever going to catch in your life. Hooked up with my good buddy Josh McKay. He's got it right down to a T, how to find the fish, how to fish for them, and man oh man, did we ever catch and release some big, beautiful Ontario black slabs.
But wanted to go scouting, hooked up with a buddy, Josh McKay. He said, let's go look for some main lake basin fish. We scouted a bunch of shorelines and stuff with traditional floats, crappie magnet, slab magnet. Man, we worked it hard, hard. Decided to pick up this instead right here, dudes. Okay. He's got these jigs. Northern Tackle Company. He makes these jigs. Fantastic little things. All different styles of hooks. All the popular models you know. But let me show you what we're going to release. Then I'll show you a real quick rundown on what we did. Because you can do it. Until these fish get real shallow, the water is real still like 43 to 46, 47. They're not where you want them to be in that skinny little water. But I'll show you what happens when you turn the trolling motor and the boat around, go out towards the first edges and drops and main lake on where you're fishing, what's sitting out there. Now, check this out. This is called Respect the Fisheries right here, okay? Beautiful, more than a handful, big black crappie getting prepared to do their business. Ready, big girl? Isn't that a beautiful fish? But that's not it. Watch this. Oh my goodness me. It's almost like a bass. Look at that thing. Hey? What do you think about Ontario now? Seriously, that is a King Kong slab crappie right there. And let her go, do her business for another day to make more babies. Ready, big girl? Go on. See ya. This is what we did. Picked up the Bucks Graphite crappie spinning rod, 6 foot, 6'5", 6 pound test, monofilament, little Pro 100 reels, and just fish below the boat. Watch the sonar, look for fish, and just like walleye fishing. I tell you what, us northern boys, we love to fish walleye, and it comes in handy fishing these deep crappie before they get into 3 and 4 feet of water, and you just pound them with the float. But until that happens, pick up the little jigs, ball heads, same way you fish for walleye, but we put on the little crappie magnet. We had the slab magnet on first, nothing. They wanted it small, they wanted it slow, and just bounce on the bottom the exact same way you fish for walleyes. That's how we did it. We caught a whole bunch of them, let a bunch go, scouted for a show. But when you want to get them in the next couple weeks, until it gets hot, until that water gets in the, I'd say mid-50s, low-60s, pull your boat out, set a point to the shoreline, turn around, look for the first breaks, trust your electronics, fish slow and methodical, pretend you're fishing for walleye, because those crappie, when their bellies are on the bottom, they'll still bite. One other thing we did, and you saw it before, slab bites with a crappie magnet was the 1-2 punch that smashed some of the biggest black crappie you're probably going to see in a long time. Josh told me he's got a lake with King Kong crappie. Okay, let's go. Usually float fishing and stuff. But man, last night we had ice, snow, bad north winds. So we picked up a single pole, but a different way. A crappie spinning rod, Bucks Graphite BNM, 6 pound test, and different jigs, Josh's jigs, Northern Tackle Supply. So I've got 5/32, 3/16, and 1/8. We're gonna get down on top of the crappie, jig back and forth with slab magnets. And Josh had a few bites, you know, just striking at it. So maybe we'll go down to the crappie magnet, put on some little slab bites, catch some King Kong crappie. Let's see what happens.
Ooh. There we go.
Good one?
Yeah.
Oh, Josh is. Ooh, atta boy, Josh.
Beautiful.
He knows the King Kong crappie on his lake. Oh my goodness, you should see the screen, dude.
A nice, beautiful.
Beautiful fish, Josh.
Slamming these nice. Boom. Once again, another female. Look at the size of the belly on these guys.
Yeah. Wah. We'll take pictures and let them go.
Oh, egg wagons right here.
Okay, you talk about playing risky, okay? Fishing risky. There was nothing like this one trip to Cedar Creek Lake and getting into some creeks and stuff in flooded springtime conditions with my buddy George Nealon. I mean, jig pole, little tube jigs, putting it in the nastiest stuff. We had to pull the line so the little tube jig went to the tip of the rod, put the rod tip through the branches, into the spots, and then let go of the line, let the line fall down, and as much area as we had, just slowly jig the jig pole and wait for the tick, and then it was all pandemonium in this line-breaking, crazy sticks and branches of the creeks.
Now this is fun, catching them, missing them, because you look at it and think, oh, come on, those guys are missing a few fish and stuff too, but I tell you, it is not easy. But is it fun? You bet. Catching them real close to you, 10 feet away, sitting in brush that you can't see them. You're putting the bait down there, you're shaking it, and all of a sudden, boom, there's a crappie.
Oh, I seen that bite. Good fish. Good fish.
Crappie. I let him take it for an extra second, George. Look where he's got it too. Look at that. Right through that top lip, boy. There's no way anybody's going to miss that bite. It's like, boom. And look where he got it too. Now as for the baits, 1/8 ounce, little ball jig head, and little chartreuse and black tube jig. Thread it up, and you know, it's got a gap is very important, because if you have too much gap here and too much bite, you can see what we're fishing. It's really heavy stuff, and it's brush and grass and stuff that you're always going to get hooked up. You get frustrated. You find the perfect matchup that is just almost in line with the tube. You got a nice little bite there for those bigger sized fish to get inside the meat. But the black and chartreuse with the pink head, you know, it's had some floods and rains and things like that, so the creek is a little bit off color. That's a ticket today. There he is. Look at that. There he is.
In the boat.
Buddy, you get that is amazing, man. Huh? How many times did
Look
he hit it?
Look at the colors.
Yeah.
He hit it three times.
Wow. Look at the gamin. Hey?
Mm-hmm.
Where he was.
Right on the thin side.
Wow. 10-incher?
You bet.
Now you talk about somebody who knows how to find fish. My good buddy, Roger Stegall from Mississippi, he fishes all over Pickwick Lake. He knows everything, man. The smallmouth, the largemouth, you name it. But the spring crappie, I was fortunate one time to get out with Roger, and he said, we're going to fish the same way you do, Carl, for like walleye. Pitching out little paddle tail, little baits out there, skipping on the bottom, lift and drop, lift and drop. And Roger showed me way back, way before there's all this kind of imaging things, of how to read the bottom. What looks like little stumps is actually crappie with their belly on the bottom, and how to fish for them. Don't just drift over them. Get right on top of them. Put it on their nose. That little thing that looks like lasagna on the sonar is actually crappie.
On Pickwick Lake, out of Muscle Shoals, Alabama, with my good friend, Roger Stegall. Roger guides full-time for bass, stripers, crappie, you name it. But this time of year, when the crappie are plentiful, they're biting, they're everywhere, he knows where to find them, he knows how to catch them. So we came down here to have some fun in good old Sweet Home, Alabama, catch some crappie, meet some good people, have some good times, just like we always do in the deep south. So sit back, enjoy, and we'll show you how Pickwick Lake is a place you should consider when you want to go crappie fishing in the spring, summer, fall, winter, it doesn't matter. Whenever you want to go, Muscle Shoals, Alabama is waiting for you.
What we're going to do today is we're going to fish for some crappie. And the way I fish for crappie is a lot like I'm bass fishing. We're going to be casting little 1/8 ounce and 1/16 ounce jigs, just tight lining. And I think we'll catch some fish today. We got water rising. As you can see out in the lake, it's trash everywhere. But I think we should have a good day. We've been catching a lot of crappie and it'll be a good time to fish today.
How about color-wise and stuff, Roger? Did it make a big difference?
We got clouds right now, and the chartreuse does better right now. Chartreuse in red, solid chartreuse, chartreuse glitter, some of the tuxedo color, chartreuse in black. Pink and black, those colors are real good.
Right on, okay, let's have some fun.
Try that one, and I'm gonna try the
okay.
Same color. Start with. All right, you'll cast him out there. Let it go all the way to the bottom. When it goes slack, you know you're on the bottom. And then you start reeling it real slow like this. Then you stop it, let it fall back. When the line goes slack again, you know it's on the bottom. And you reel it again until you go slack.
And usually they're there, thump, or they're just there, right?
When it's falling, it'll go thump. Or your line will just tighten up, or you'll see your line go to moving off to the side. There's two or three different ways that they'll bite it. But the ideal situation is when you stop it, he goes thump. You see your line jump. I mean, it'll jump when he gets it.
Here we are, right there.
There we go, right there.
Right there, Roger. Boy, he thumped that
good
too.
Deal.
Oh, nice crappie too. Look at that.
Put them in the boat.
Wow, look at them colors on that thing. That didn't take
what
long.
About that? That's about your third hey? Cast, wasn't it?
Does Roger know where to go? You're right. It wasn't really even in a thump either. It was all of a sudden he's just there.
And it's there. Boom. That's right.
You know? Nice crappie.
They'll thump it sometimes.
That's a nice way to start, huh?
Shower rain.
Now is Pickwick on right away, but a little bit of drizzle and rain, who cares? I got rain gear. Roger's got rain gear. We're gonna try to catch some crappie and have some fun and then eat them later. Come on, crappie. Come on, crappie. Just sitting all over this flat, eh?
We might catch one out of here while we're being movie stars.
How many years now have you been guiding now?
Start my 28th year.
Wow.
We could go out right there, see that dot right there, and we might catch one. I got something that feels soft for you. Feels like line. You pop it like that right there if you don't get it. Feels like it might be on some line. But take it like this, pop it like that, and it come right loose. Magical hands. That's what a boy told me one day. Had magical hands.
Thanks, Roger.
Come yeah. on now, crappie.
Nice when you feel that little thump or the weight.
Yep. Got him.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good crappie.
Yep.
I think that's the bass fisherman.
Look where you got it.
Crappie.
Identical to the other one, huh?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I must have landed close to this one's head, Roger, because as soon as it went down.
You got it.
Ooh, look, that's a little bit of weight on them.
Yeah, that's a good crappie.
Pan-sized.
That's a black crappie there now.
It, oh, yeah, right.
Yeah, speckle
right.
is.
Yeah, yep. No mm-hmm. bars, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Nice. Look where he's got it, too.
Yeah.
Just in the nose, boy. He's got a damaged eye, isn't he?
Yeah, it looks like he's one-eyed.
Yeah, it's like a cat.
Yep.
But he can still find the bait.
Yep, that's a good fish.
Poor him. Now he goes in the live well. Look at his one eye here. I'm going to show you this. Look at his eye. It's a one-eyed crappie. He's like a pirate.
Yeah.
There's a good one. And here he goes, into the box, join his friend. All it is, there's so many different ways we're catching them.
I've got a good guide.
Oh, yeah. See, that's what a good guide does. He puts the guys on the fish so the customers and clients catch them. He's caught so many crappie and bass in his life, he doesn't even care. But when the customer, like me, that's what I am today. Like a co-pilot customer, I'm catching them. I feel great. Like a crappie superstar. Let's keep going.
In here, we'll get it right quick.
Nice. Oh, I missed one right there. Do you believe that? I felt it all the way to my hand and I had all that slack in the line. What the heck?
Good one.
A netter?
Might be.
Uh-oh.
If it's a crappie. It's a big old crappie, too.
Is it?
Yeah, boy. Barely hooked.
Oh, boy. Oh, is that a nice one, Roger? Yes, yeah. Sir.
What about that?
Yeah, man.
Jig where it's at. It fell out of his mouth.
And you just changed the colors, too, didn't you?
Yep. Turn that in live well right quick and I'll get it out of there.
Okay. Look at that, man. Fishing Pickwick.
All right.
Good stuff, Roger. Look at the shoulders on him. All nice and thick. Big mouth. What do you say, crappie? You should have kept that yap closed, but now you got it caught and feed us.
I don't know about them Canadians kissing them.
We've had rain, drizzle, wind, doesn't matter what it is. We come out here to Alabama and have some fun with Roger, catching some crappie. And again, we do spider rigging, trolling, pulling cranks, bobbers, corks, whatever it is. But today, casting, just like a little crankbait, slow roll off the bottom. They're all over the water column. Roger talked about the lake coming up 3 feet in the last 3 days because of all the rain and stuff, but we're still catching them. We're having fun, and you can too, right here, Muscle Shoals, Alabama, Pickwick Lake, with my buddy Roger Stegall. Fishing right below the boat.
I've seen them sit there. Like I said, it looks like lasagna laying on the bottom.
Right.
They won't be separated from the bottom. A lot of people think it's a stump.
Mm-hmm.
You drop that sucker down there, you'll see if it's a stump or not.
That's right.
And just go thump.
Because it did look like stumps.
Yeah. There's a fish right there. Get ready. There's a jig. Got him. Big one.
Oh, boy. You can swing this one?
I'll net it for you.
Okay. Wow, Roger, that is something else, huh?
Look at that.
You tell me that's not fun, man. Seeing them on the sonar and popping them. And look where they're getting it, too.
Yep. Right.
Look
top
at that.
Of my head.
You never miss those ones, do you? Boy.
Good fish.
That's a bad spot getting them in that. Yeah. The hole gets too big, huh?
Yeah, that's right. Or over in here in this lip right over in here.
Yes.
Over in that tender side. Yeah. You get them in the top of the head.
Yeah.
He's caught.
Awesome, boy. Awesome, man. This is now turning into fun. I mean, it was fun before, but when you see them like that,
yeah.
when you figuring it out, right? Because they're not chasing it that much anymore.
That's
and as soon
right.
as you say they're below the boat, and sometimes, what did you say again? They look like a stump.
That's right.
But it's not a
it
stump.
It looks like lasagna. That's what it looks like. Laying on the bottom. That reddish looking color.
And it's these things.
That's right. I've caught too many of them doing that.
Nice stuff. Let's put them in here.
Start off casting. And we're throwing a 7-foot ultralight with a little 1,000 spinning reel with 6-pound line. And you throw a little 1/8-ounce jig head, put a wedge tail. And you try to keep it on there straight. You just put it on, just like this right here, just thread him on there and keep that wedge tail in line with your hook. Just bring it on there just like that right there and push it up on there. And that little tail just kicks like the dickens when you're swimming it. And we started off throwing this morning, casting, tight line is what we call it. And that's where I usually catch them. But today, the water, since yesterday, I guided yesterday, and since yesterday, the water's came up about a foot, foot and a half, and it continues to rise today. And as you notice, there's a lot of trash on the water. So what we ended up doing, catching a lot of our fish, is we'd actually see them on my hummingbird up there. These hummingbird electronics is just unbelievable now. We'd see him on the hummingbird, drop it down straight to him, and catch a fish right under the boat. There's something right there. Got him. There you go.
Boy, you. Did he hit that, Roger.
He liked it, didn't he?
Yes, sir. Right through the schnoz, too. But you couldn't have planned that better.
That
you just finished saying, hey, there's one right there. Gotta love
That's
it.
That's the way to do it.
Yep. My jig going up and down. You see a fish, drop it down, hold it steady, and don't even do anything. These fish are like, they went from chasing it a bit this morning to now you gotta put it right on top of their nose, hold it, and then it's dunk, game on. Pretty fun stuff. Catching them with the jig. Got them? Got a boy, Roger.
Saw good one? Down there. Pretty good one.
Need a net?
Nah, I got it.
Oh, look at that. Nice crappie.
Good one. Look at that.
Right below the boat.
Good one. Saw him on the screen. I just kept fluttering it along there and caught him. Good deal. That there's a good eater.
I'd say. And we just feather it on like this. You find where the head is there. The little tail vibrates. You come down. Just push it on to the jig head. Spin it around, and that's it. You're all ready to go. We only had about 4 hours. He came out this morning around 7:30, 8 o'clock. Time to get out, it's about 12:30 now. So you know what? Having a good day, a good feed of crappie. And once again, another lake on our show. catching them with another guy who really knows, got them dialed in to how to catch them full time. Roger Stegall, big time. Let's go and try to catch a few more. Here we go. Come on.
There's one.
Going?
Yeah.
Atta boy.
Got one. Good one.
Good one?
Yeah.
Netter?
Yeah.
A netter. All right. I like to hear that. Roger says it's a netter. It's a netter. Big crappie.
Big crappie. Ready?
Oh, look at him fight. Oh, that's a nice crappie. Atta boy, Roger. Oh, back. Nice one, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir. Wow.
Very nice to bait.
Atta boy. Atta boy.
Good fish. Look at that. Ooh. Yeah. All right.
There's another one there, Roger.
You got one?
Yeah, a big one, too.
Big one. You need the net.
No, I'll scoop them. Let's see. Maybe. Yes.
There.
Almost double header on Pickwick, huh?
I guarantee you, that one on right at the top of the head.
Yes, sir.
Good fish.
Right on. Thanks, buddy. I saw, like you said, a brush pile or something.
Yeah.
All thick right there.
Yeah.
I put it down. Boom.
Boom.
So it's right over here somewhere, right?
Yeah, I know where it is.
Okay. I'm sure you do. You brought us right out here. So, you know, it's like the smart old dog. He lets all the young dogs hunt all day long. And then he goes to where he knows the game is. Just,
yeah.
I got to catch some fish now.
See all this white hair? That's wisdom.
I ain't got any up here.
Yeah, I know. Yours all cut out.
Makes me actually swim faster.
Oh, does it? No. I hope I ain't going to be swimming down here in the future.
And if you would like to experience this awesome crappie fishing on Pickwick Lake with Roger, give him a call at 662.
And last but not least, number 10. This was one of the most inexpensive yet deadliest techniques I've ever fished for crappie. With the Duck Commanders, John Godwin, Jay Stone on Lake Darbonne, pulling little mini planer board corks, pushing the baits off to the side, because we all know how walleyes and crappie and fish like that get spooked by the boats and stuff. How do you catch them with it? It was such a great way to do it with a very inexpensive little system. I'll let Jay explain how he did it, but man, I mean, it was phenomenal. Putting out to the sides and just watch those little corks get buried by crappie.
The guys just pulled up. I'm gonna get ready to head over to them, get in their boat and have some fun. Let's go see.
So we get word that Carl's coming back, so I gotta go find some fish. I locate some fish, but there's only one problem. We have bad weather coming in. High winds, rain in the forecast, so we gotta put together a game plan. But I noticed early that morning the wind was gonna be light enough where we can try out our new planer board, planer cork, long lining technique.
So, well, you noticed on the graph we'd see the fish on our side image, and you'd see them, but they'd always be to the side in that shallow water, so they go around that boat.
Right.
It's a cork with a fin. And what that does, that allows you to get the baits away from the boat. You know, a lot of times we deal with spooky fish around here, they get hammered pretty hard. All right, what we have here is a miniature version of a planer board, okay? The crappie version. But this is a planer cork. Pretty much serves the same purpose. And we're going to be using our long lining technique. The only difference is, instead of having a rooster tail behind the boat, we're going to have a peacock tail.
Gotcha.
You know, yes. More baits in the water.
Yes.
A bigger spread.
Long lining's kind of like the crankbait of bass fishing. It's a good way to find fish real quick to see if they're there. And they're supposed to be there. And if they're there, the long lining's going to get them. And these new corks are going to spread way out, and we're really going to cover some water this year. Now, I've changed my technique.
You have?
Yeah. I had last year, we had all six-footers back here.
Yes.
But now I got 10, 8, and 6s.
Ah, okay.
So it gives a little bit better separation.
So right off the bat, rods are out there. He's got the 10-foot, 8-foot, and an ultralight. Bam, right away, Goblin catch a fish, just like before. You sure it's a fish?
Oh, yeah.
You need a net?
Come here, crappie.
Net it?
I ain't got it out.
Hey, we don't even have a net.
I got the net, but it's not out. But look, he choked that sucker.
Well, that's a nice one too. Oh, got one already. Look it. Well, I don't need to have to grab it because he's already got it. Look.
Godwin knows crappie.
We got one.
Is that fast enough, folks?
Look how deep that is.
Wow.
Watch him.
Where's he?
Oh, good night. If I was in a tournament, that'd give me a heart attack.
Wouldn't Jay just be like, what are you doing?
What are you doing in the world?
We didn't have a whole lot of time before that wind picked up. So I'd say hour and a half, that's about all we had. So I told Carl, I said, oh, we got to make hay while the sun's shining. So let's get out there and get after it. We got the poles out, we got the corks out, and we got on some good fish, which took a little pressure off of me.
You know what? What the? That's a crappie.
And Goblin goes, take your shoes off. Take my shoes off. You know what? Fish barefoot for crappie? All right.
Carl got crappie.
Crappie Carl.
Always staying down too. Is it a good one or is it a cat? Oh, look at this thing. Oh, I think that's a good crappie. Where are you? Tuck on my line. Oh no, he looks like a good one, John. The barefoot system seems to be working.
Barefoot.
I'm gonna come in between here.
Come on in here. We got him.
Nice, nice. Wow. I'm liking this.
And I have a quarter ounce slip sinker about a foot above that jig. So what that does is, when you're going 1 mile an hour, which is what we normally go long lining, you got about a 45 degree drag up underneath that cork. So if you want to fish 3 foot deep, you let out 6 foot of line.
Gotcha.
One right here. Oh, you need a netter?
Here you go.
Oh,
look at Stone go. Another chunker too. Nice one, Jay. Two systems, out to the side, out to the back. Boy, oh boy. Like a lawnmower cutting grass, right?
Yep.
Wide range. Great system.
We're cutting a good path. Here.
Another one?
Help. Yeah, I got two of them.
Uh-oh. You have to put that net down if he's too big. Goblin's got two. I got none. How's that? And I think I'm still... No, I'm around his tip of his rod.
Oh, are you?
Yeah. Look at this. This is something, eh, Jay?
Here.
Rod tips need to go towards me.
Yeah, come back this way a bit, John. There's one. I think that's mine, yes? Or actually it's John's, but mine. And he scoops him in the boat, like a big fat bass.
We just sitting here jigging like a bunch of schoolgirls. Ain't crappie fishing fun.
Rod's going up, stumps, net, wow.
If you think this is easy, you're misled, because there's a system to this. It's not just throwing the bait out the back of the boat and hopefully, you know, you're not getting stuck. Hopefully fish sees your bait. You know, it's the right size bait, line, speed, control, everything, all those elements put together, puts those fish in the boat.
John, what again, you said 10 foot, 8 foot, 5 foot?
Yeah, okay. 10 foot on the ends, 8 foot in the middle, 6 foot on the inside.
Okay.
That gives you about 2 foot in between each one.
Yeah.
A little bit better.
Yes.
Just a little better.
See, the average guy will watch this and think, oh, they're just trolling. But you've got a lot of little things involved in the elements, right?
Right.
The size of the jig, the length of the poles. So it's not just pick up any rods and just drag them behind the boat.
No, right. You need to vary your weight on your jig head depending on the depth of water you're fishing. We're fishing 5 to 6 foot of water, so... Yeah, with speed too. We're using 16th ounce jig head. We used 1/32nd and 1/16th last year. And we went to all 1/16th this year because the water's up a little bit. We've had a lot of rain. So we had to get down a little bit deeper because them fish were staging and up on the flat and staying close to the bottom.
I got Goblin's rod. I have to give him his pole again. You know why? He's got another big Oh boy, Jay, look at this. Another monster. I feel guilty bringing it in, folks, seriously.
No, bring it in.
Okay, hear what he said? The chef said bring it in. Oh my goodness, Jay.
Let me know when he gets
Look at that. Oh yeah. Oh, look at him. Beautiful crappie. I'll swing him. I'll swing him. Goblin's fish. Oh, my my goodness. You talk about teamwork. Godwin's tying up my bait. See his rod go down. I lift up, and a beautiful crappie. That's what friends do for friends when you're crappie fishing.
That's right.
If he's gonna cook them, and I get to eat them, at least I can help him bring them in.
You get the spider rigging so long, you get your casting gets kind of lacking.
Yes.
But once you start doing this again, you get pinpointed back in there.
Very much so, yeah. The big one?
He feels good.
Okay.
He feels good.
Oh. I think you're over it.
He's hung up in that line. Yeah. Get over here.
Look at him fight. My goodness. Come here, crappie. Oh, Lordy.
Got him.
Oh, yes. Goblin's got three good ones in a row. Look at that. Man, are they beautiful fish.
Oh, that's a good one, eh?
Yes, sir.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on all our pages dedicated to crappie in the links below in the description section of this video.